All right, so welcome back to another episode on the Freedom. Same thing, only the roles will be switched. I'll kneel myself, or not kneel, but I'll like prop myself up against the tree.
Say hello to the sky, Cam.
You start off over there at the front. All right, so funny enough, we're going to be talking about the ammo shortage once again. I would say, if you're going to be on this channel a lot, expect weekly updates. Every time we do a video, we're probably going to be talking about the ammunition shortage, at least in our area. And today, I had an incredible find. I couldn't really even believe...
A gold mine.
...that I found it.
So to speak.
Of all places. In Walmart. Believe that, in Walmart, I found some Winchester 7.62 by 5.1. Other words, we got some 308 here. As you can see back there, M1 Garand, not really an M1 Garand, it's an M1A Springfield Armory. Late version, semi-automatic, box-fed magazine version of the M1 Garand from World War II. We're gonna mess around with it some here in a little bit, and I just wanted to let everybody know that we found some of this in Walmart. I couldn't even believe it. Now, there was still... The whole ammo case that Walmart actually has behind the counter was still empty. There was about 12 or 13 boxes of this. And I actually seen a sign next to it that said there was a 3-box limit. So unfortunately, I was able to get 3 of these only. But, you know, it's better than nothing. And the price, it was still pretty expensive. But, I mean, compared to what I paid for the Fiocchi, I paid almost $90 for...
Bam.
3 boxes.
That's ridiculous, man.
Yeah. So this was just barely over $70 for all 3 of these 20 rounds. Let's see, 149 grain, 2700, basically 2800 feet per second. Yeah, FMJs, man. And I really couldn't even believe it. So as soon as I seen it, I'm like, I'll take those.
I'll take all you got.
Yeah.
But you won't let me.
I wish I would have had a buddy with me.
But you won't take it all. No. Well, let me take it all.
No, they wouldn't let me. They wouldn't let me. Oh, well.
It's a problem.
We're going to fire this bad boy some more and hope you guys stick around to
get
watch
some
that.
Some long-range shots for you.
Yes. So, we'll see you guys here shortly.
On the range.
All right. So, here we go. We're going to try this out again. I'm going to go for the 100-yard shot. Which is the far orange target, as far down range as we can get. It's a hit. Another hit. Another hit.
Try the 85er.
On the right hand side. Go for the middle one. I think I got one shot left. Broke it. So as you can see, this gun is very, very accurate. It's not only very accurate, but it's a fantastic gun to shoot. We already did the review on this, and I'm talking kind of loud because I got these earmuffs on, but we broke the target. The far one is holding up okay so far. I loaded 5 rounds in a magazine. Every shot was a hit. The peep sights on this are awesome. And we're going to let Dylan take a hit with this now and see how he does.
Fucking target yet. Okay, so that last clip, obviously, I hit the target twice out of five shots. I've never shot that gun before. Them sights are pretty small, but they're very accurate.
Very small sights.
Very small, but they're very accurate. And I can't hardly see that damn in there with the hell. So we'll try it again next week. We'll get them targets somehow brightened up a little bit and try it again.
I will say next week we're going to do another video on this gun, and I should by then have everything that I ordered for it. We got the M2 bipod on the way and the extended magazine. I'm going to take some more shots with this gun. And it is a very hard thing to use these sights because they are very small. But that's what you get when you're getting this gun. It's a marksman's rifle. Very, very small sights. So let's go ahead and give it a shot. Again. So I'm going to fire at the 100 yards again, and we'll see what happens here. Normally I try to shoot with both eyes open, but I'm going to be closing one eye. Fantastic gun to shoot, man. Expect a lot of videos on this thing because it's honestly my favorite gun that I own. And it's fun to shoot at long range like that. Yeah, so stay tuned. We're going to be doing more videos on it in the future. So, guys, thanks for watching this episode of Freedom and Firearms. And Dylan will sign us off.
Okay, so next week, he's going to be absent. So me and Bill, the cameraman, we're going to be back in the studio recording some videos for y'all, so won't be in the range next week. Be back on the Constitutional Colonials channel. Links in the description, as always. Make sure you join the FPC and the GOA. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and our other channel, and like us on Facebook. See y'all in the next one.
They'll come loud and they'll come fast.
We shoot first and we can last. Keep your rifle.